God rest ye merry gentlemen, let nothing you dismay. Remember Christ our Savior was born on Christmas Day, to save us all from Satan's power when we were gone astray. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy.
Tonight, we will endeavor, in this ghostly little story,
to give rise to the ghost of an idea.
Let nothing you see tonight frighten you,
or alarm you,
or upset you.
But rather, let it make you ponder this question.
What would it take to make you understand the true meaning of Christmas?
From God our Heavenly Father, a blessed angel came, and unto certain shepherds brought tidings of the same, how that in Bethlehem was born the Son of God by name. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy.
Sorry, sir. Merry Christmas.
Bah, humbug.
A humbug? But it's Christmas, sir.
Is that any reason to be assaulted by a common criminal?
But she's just a child, sir.
That, my good woman, is her fault. Your problem, and none of my concern. Good day.
Oh, what a terrible man. Who was he?
Oh, I'm afraid that terrible man, for better or worse, was my dear uncle, Ebenezer Scrooge.
Oh, I'm terribly sorry.
For him or for me?
No, I meant...
Oh, no harm done. My uncle has provided me hours of merriment, though he seems to take none for himself. Well, Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas to you, sir.
Uncle Scrooge!
And with that, you have made the acquaintance of Mr. Ebenezer Scrooge and his nephew, Fred.
One of them is a tight-fisted, wrenching, grasping, covetous old sinner.
And the other is his nephew, Fred.
Scrooge, having just concluded business at the King's Bench, was returning to the office of Marley and Scrooge.
Good day to you, sir.
Good day.
Pardon, sir, are you the proprietor of this establishment?
Indeed I am, and my work could be better accomplished if I were allowed to enter.
Pardon, sir, do we have the pleasure of addressing Mr. Marley or Mr. Scrooge?
Ha! You'd have a hard time indeed addressing Mr. Marley, sir. He's been dead for 7 years and is currently 6 feet under. Now, if you'll excuse me.
But sir, if we may state the nature of our business.
Have I any hope of stopping you?
At this festive season of the year, Mr. Scrooge, it is desirable that we make provisions for the poor and destitute who suffer greatly at this present time.
Yes, sir, hundreds are in want of basic necessities. Thousands even are in want.
Are there no prisons?
Yes, sir, plenty of prisons.
And the union workhouses are still in operation?
Well, sadly, they are, sir.
The treadmill and poor laws are in full vigor, then?
Why, both very busy, sir.
Oh. I was afraid from what you had first said that something had occurred to stop them in their most useful course. I'm very glad to hear it.
Well, seeing that they scarcely furnish cheer of mind or of body to the multitude, we're here in hopes to raise a fund to buy the poor some meat and drink and means of warmth.
Some small measure of Christmas cheer.
But why now, gentlemen? Are the poor only hungry at this time of year?
Well, no. I mean, yes. That is to say...
We chose this time of year because in this holiday season, want is more keenly felt, and abundance rejoices.
Fine sentiment, sir. You're a brighter candle than your friend.
So what may we put you down for, sir?
Nothing.
Ah, so you wish to remain anonymous?
I wish to be left alone! Unless it falls on a Sunday, and this year it does not. Christmas is just another workday. I do not make merry on workdays, and I cannot afford to make idle people merry. I help support the establishments I have mentioned. They cost enough, and those who are badly off must go there.
But, sir, many cannot.
And many would rather die.
Then let them die! And decrease the surplus population! Good day to you, sirs!
Uncle Ebenezer!
Cratchit! They're after me! Lock that door!
Merry Christmas, Bob Cratchit.
Oh, Merry Christmas, sir.
Uncle, you didn't see me on the street earlier.
I noticed you. I was escaping.
But I wanted to wish you a Merry Christmas.
Bah, humbug.
Christmas, a humbug? Uncle!
Yes, a humbug. What right have you to be merry? You're poor enough.
What right do you have to be dismal? You're rich enough.
Bah, humbug!
Don't be cross.
Don't be cross. What else can I be when I live in a world of fools such as these, who one day a year turn into grinning idiots full of good intentions and merriment? If I had my way, everyone that goes about with Merry Christmas would be boiled to death in his own pudding and buried with a stake of holly through his heart.
Uncle!
Nephew! Keep Christmas in your way and let me keep it in mine.
Keep it? That's just it. You don't keep it.
Then let me leave it alone! What is it about this one day that turns grown men into children? Much good it has ever done you! Much good it will ever do you!
Uncle, there are many things from which I have derived good that have brought me no profit. Christmas among the rest. But there is something special about this time of year. Apart from it being the most sacred of days, it is, Uncle, a kind time, a charitable, forgiving time, where we view one another not as strangers bound on disparate journeys, but rather as fellow travelers to the grave. And although it has not put a scrap of gold or silver in my pocket, I do believe it has done me good and will continue to do me good. So for that, I say, God bless it.
Let me hear another sound out of you, and you'll spend Christmas by losing your situation. You're quite a powerful speaker, sir. I wonder you aren't in Parliament.
Well, all my talents do come from my favorite uncle, who happens to be my only uncle. Come, dine with us tomorrow night. Jane and I would be delighted to have you.
My dear nephew, I'd see you in hell first!
But why?
Why? Why? Why did you get married?
Why? Because I fell in love.
Because you fell in love.
I don't see what that has anything to do with—
Good day!
Uncle Ebony—
I said good day!
Uncle, we have never had any reason to quarrel, and I have made this trial in homage to Christmas. You may say it's a humbug, but I will keep my Christmas humor till the last. So, Merry Christmas, Uncle!
Bah!
And a Happy New Year!
Bah!
Merry Christmas, Bob Cratchit.
Merry Christmas, Fred.
Humbug! Humbug, I say!
Oh.
And you. You grinning orangutan. I suppose you want all day tomorrow.
Sir?
I suppose you want all day tomorrow to celebrate the holiday.
Oh, yes, yes. If quite convenient, sir.
If quite convenient.
It's not convenient! Why should I pay for a whole day of work when a day of work is not done?
It's just one day a year, sir.
Poor excuse for picking a man's pocket every 25th of December. Be here all the earlier the next day,
yes,
and I hope for your sake it's an unusually warm December 26th, for you have used up this month's allotment of coal.
But, sir, it has been a particularly cold winter.
Not as cold as it'll be without a fire in that stove. And it will remain unlit until further notice. Coal is a luxury I cannot afford, especially when I have an employee who takes banker's holidays every 25th of December. Good night, Cratchit.
Oh, sir, sir, Merry—
Don't say it, Cratchit.
Have a good evening, sir.
Bah, humbug. Ah, home. Home. Home at last.
Scrooge!
Who's there? Bah! I say!
Ebenezer Scrooge.
Who said that? Who are you?
Ebenezer Scrooge.
I am Ebenezer Scrooge. Who are you?
I am your partner, Ebenezer.
My partner was Jacob Marley.
And it is he who addresses you now.
Bah! Jacob Marley's been dead and gone these 7 years.
Dead, Ebenezer, but not gone.
Not gone? You cannot be he.
I will visit you tonight. Be ready for me, Ebenezer Scrooge.
Wait. Who are you? You're not Marley. You cannot be. If you were sent to play a trick on me, I assure you, I am not in the least bit amused. Do you hear? I'm not scared. I'm not fooled by any of this. When a man works as hard as I do, his tired eyes can play tricks on him. That's the end of it. Good night, then. Ha! Jacob Marley indeed. Ha! Visit me. Visit me. As if I had time for visitors. Ooh, cup of tea, milk, sugar. Bah! Visit one of those mindless holiday fools in the street. Not a hard-working businessman like myself. My time is valuable. Do you hear? Far too valuable for foolishness. Foolishness, I say. Hello? Where are you, Jacob Marley? Cat got your tongue? At a loss for words? Ha! Nowhere to be found!
Ebenezer Scrooge!
Who are you? What do you want with me?
I want much.
But who are you?
Ask who I was.
Who were you then?
In life, I was your partner, Jacob Marley.
No, you cannot be. Jacob Marley's been dead and gone these 7 years.
Dead, Ebenezer, but not gone.
Humbug. I can't believe it. I won't believe it.
Do you see me?
Yes.
Do you hear me?
I do.
Then why do you doubt your senses?
Senses? Least little thing can affect the senses. You may be the result of bad digestion. An undigested bit of beef. Ah, yes. There's more of gravy than grave about you, sir. Ah! Ah! Why?
Why do you believe in me?
I do. I must. But why do you come to me?
To save you, Ebenezer!
From what, Jacob?
From yourself! It is required of every man that he walk abroad amongst his fellow men. If he does not do this in life, then he is condemned to do it in death.
You are chained, Jacob. Tell me why.
I wear the chains in death that I forged in life. Link by link, I girded this of my own free will. Does the pattern look strange to you, Ebenezer? On the day of my death, ours were even, but yours has had 7 years to grow.
No, Marley, no. Speak comfort to me.
I have no comfort to give. Little more is permitted of me.
Wait, Jacob, stay.
I cannot stay. I cannot rest. I cannot linger anywhere. Do you not see, Ebenezer? When I lived, if ever I truly lived, my spirit never wandered beyond our counting house. I never once looked up from the grubby confines of the money-changing hole that bore our names. And now I must atone for all my sins in an agony of restless, never-ending death.
You were always a great man of business, Jacob.
Mankind was my business! Charity my business! Mercy! Welfare of my fellow man! That was my business! Oh, at this time of the rolling year, I suffer most! Why do I walk around amongst my fellow beings with my eyes turned down and never once look up to that blessed star that led the wise men to a poor abode? Were there no poor homes to which its light may have conducted me? Hear me!
Is this my future too, Jacob? Jacob, tell me, is there no hope for me?
This is why I visit, that you might escape my fate!
Anything, Marley. Tell me what to do. Tell me what not to do.
Turn the road, Ebenezer, before the road runs out!
But how, Jacob?
No more words from me, Ebenezer.
No, Jacob, stay. Tell me how.
You will be visited tonight by three spirits.
No, Jacob, do not send them. Let me learn from you.
Three spirits, Ebenezer. Without them, you cannot hope to shun the path that I tread. Expect the first when the clock strikes one.
I think I'd rather have them all at once.
The next will come 1 hour later, and the third when the clock chimes three. Expect no more of our company, but forget not what has come between us.
Bah! Humbug!
And with that, due to the emotions of the day, Scrooge made his way to his bed and promptly fell asleep. Bum, 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 bum. Bum, 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 bum. Bum, 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 bum. Bum, 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 bum. Bum.
Bah! 1 o'clock and all is well. No visitors to my bedchamber. No spirits to disturb my sleep. No apparitions to frighten the senses. It was just a dream, Ebenezer. Just a dream. Are you the spirit whose coming was foretold to me?
I am, Ebenezer.
Who are you?
I am the ghost of Christmas past.
Long past?
No, Ebenezer. Your past. Your Christmas past.
What is your business here?
Your welfare and your reclamation. Rise and walk with me. But when? Tonight we travel 50 years into the past. Look around you. You'll recognize someone soon.
I see only a young man. A student. Why is he alone? Where are his classmates?
Where indeed, Ebenezer, where indeed? Look closer.
His face is familiar, but the surroundings are a mystery. Is this the child of an acquaintance spirit?
Look closer.
Spirit.
Who do you see, Ebenezer?
It is I, ghost of the past. You have shown me myself.
And why are you alone?
All the others have left for home to celebrate Christmas with their families.
Had you no family?
I did. Of course I did.
And why are you alone?
My father was not a man given to celebration.
He required that you stay in school and continue to study?
Yes.
Even though all the other children were allowed to return home?
Yes. All of them. Even my...
Go on, Ebenezer.
Poor boy. Poor boy. I do not wish to relive this spirit.
You must.
I cannot.
Then I will help you.
Ebenezer!
Fan.
It's Fan.
Oh, dear brother. I've come to bring you home. Home.
Home?
Yes, home. For good and all. Home forever and ever. Father is so much kinder than he used to be. At home, it's like heaven.
For you, perhaps, but not for me. He doesn't know me nor even what I look like. Same as I hardly know you, now that you're quite a woman. Mama must have looked just like you, just before she died.
Well... Perhaps that is what has changed his mind towards you. Father spoke to me so gently one night when I was going to bed that I wasn't afraid to ask him once more that you might come home. And he said, yes, you should. And he sent me in the carriage to bring you. And now you're never to come back here anymore, and you're never to be lonely again.
Never to be lonely again?
Never, as long as I live.
Then you must live forever, Fan. Nobody else ever cared for me, and nobody else ever will.
Oh, dear brother, what nonsense. Everyone loves you very much. You must forgive Papa and forget the past. For our dearest mother's sake.
Oh, Fan.
There.
Your sister was a delicate creature whom a breath might have withered. But she had a great heart.
She had.
She died a married woman and had, I think, children.
One child.
True, your nephew.
She died giving him life.
As your mother died giving you life, for which your father never forgave you, as if you were to blame. For it reminds you of her, doesn't it?
In his cheerful disposition and his kind looks, he reminds me every bit of my dear sister Fan.
Come, Ebenezer, we must go.
Please, Spirit, please. Let me see my sister just a moment longer.
There is much more to see, sir. Much more. Another Christmas.
Sing we Noel Christmas, Noel sing we here. Hear our grateful praises to the babe so dear. Sing we Noel, the King is born, Noel. Sing we Noel Christmas, sing we now Noel. Sing we Noel, the King is born, Noel. Sing we Noel Christmas, sing we now Noel.
Do you know this place?
Know it? I was apprenticed here.
Hilly ho! Let's clean out this space for the party. Books onto shelves, papers into drawers. Make room for dancing.
Why, it's old Fezziwig. Bless his heart. Fezziwig alive again.
Ebenezer Scrooge. What pray tell do you think you're doing?
Sir, I'm sorry. I know I said I would have these figures entered by close of business today, but I'm afraid I've fallen a little behind.
Young man.
I'll make it up to you, sir. I'll work through the holiday.
Am I not the master of this office?
You are, sir.
Do I not hold your livelihood in my hands?
You do.
Well then, you need to exchange that ledger for a cup of punch. Post haste.
Very good, sir. Thank
you. There can be no dancing when there's accounting still in the air. But where is my partner? Is she hiding from me?
Oh, well, for want of better partner, I allow you the pleasure.
That voice is familiar. The giggle is not unknown. To be sure, I've held these hands before. Strike up the band. Take your places. But who is there to dance with the lovely bell?
Well, sir, I spy a very eligible young gentleman. Oh! Come, sir. Your partner awaits. Oh.
Hello, Ebenezer. May I have this dance?
Hello, Belle. You may, but I'm afraid I don't make much of a partner.
Well, I should warn you. I won't take no for an answer.
Oh, please, Belle.
Right here. Very good.
Thank you.
Spirit a happy time indeed. Dear old Fezziwig, he was good to us.
A small matter to make these silly folks so full of gratitude.
Small?
A few shillings for some musicians and some extra for some small porter and cold roast.
Ah, Spirit, it wasn't the amount of money he spent on the celebration. He had the power to render us happy or unhappy, to make our service light or burdensome, a pleasure or a toil. Don't you see, Spirit, the happiness that he gave came just as much from his cheerful looks and his kind voice. It was worth a fortune!
What's the matter, Ebenezer?
Nothing in particular.
Something, I think.
No. I would just like to say a word or two to my clerk, Bob Cratchit, just now. That's all.
Perhaps a word or two with someone else instead.
I tried to warn you I wasn't much of a dancer.
Nonsense, sir. You are divine. A bit rigid, perhaps, but divine.
Well, thank you for your patience.
Thank you for the dance at long last. You know, I've been waiting 2 years for the chance to dance with you, Ebenezer.
You were waiting to dance with me. I was unaware.
Ebenezer, are you trembling?
Oh, no, certainly not. It's a bit cold in here, don't you think?
Yes, cold. What with all this dancing about, how could you possibly be cold? So, what are your plans for Christmas Day?
Well, I've got a lot of work to do around here, so I was...
Ebenezer, you cannot work on Christmas Day. Isn't anyone expecting you? You have nowhere to go.
I'm afraid not.
Well, you will just have to spend the day with us. It would be our pleasure to have you as a guest. My pleasure to have you.
I would be honored.
And you never left, did you?
No, I...
Go on, Ebenezer. What did you do?
I asked her for her hand in marriage.
An engagement? How delightful. You must have made a lovely couple.
We did, Spirit. We did. We were so happy together. For a time.
But something happened.
Please, Spirit. I do not wish to remember. Show this not to me now.
Observe, Ebenezer.
No.
My time grows short quickly.
Spirit, she didn't understand me. She thought me greedy and tight-fisted.
How could she have ever gotten that idea?
Ebenezer? Ebenezer, I must speak with you.
Yes.
Ebenezer, I've been trying to. That is for some time now. Ebenezer, I have been replaced in your sight.
Replaced? That's preposterous. Who could have replaced you?
An idol.
An idol.
A golden one.
How am I ever to understand this world? There's nothing it condemns with such severity as the pursuit of wealth, but yet nothing that it is harder upon than poverty.
Ebenezer, why must you fear the world so much? All of your hopes have merged into the one hope of being beyond the chance of the world's reproach.
Belle, that's not true.
It is. I have watched your nobler aspirations die one by one until only gain is left. It has changed you, has it not?
Well, if I've changed towards the world, I've not changed towards you, have I?
When our marriage contract was made, we were both poor and content to be so. I am still content, but you... You are changed. When it was made, you were another man.
I was a boy.
Now I long for that gentle, charming boy. Oh, Ebenezer, you looked at me with such a sweetness. Such a sweetness, I thought my heart would melt away. How long has it been since you looked at me that way? Months? Years? You are different now. Ebenezer, I release you.
Release? Have I ever sought release?
In words, no.
In what then?
In a changed nature, an altered spirit, in everything that ever made my love of any value to you.
I do not have time to discuss personal affairs during business hours.
Ebenezer, tell me, if this had never been between us, would you seek me out and try to win me now? A woman with no dowry? Would you? Without speaking a word, you have informed me that our contract is null and void. So, Ebenezer, I release you with a full heart of love for the man you once were.
Belle.
You may have pain in this. The memory of who you were makes me hope you will. But you will soon dismiss the recollection. Goodbye, Ebenezer. May you be happy in the life you've chosen.
Go after her!
Belle. Bah!
Are you Scrooge? Are you happy in the life you have chosen?
Spirit, show me no more. Conduct me home. I cannot bear it.
Be not angry with me, Ebenezer. These are shadowed as things that have been. The past cannot be changed. It cannot be altered.
Then why do you show me these things? To torment me?
No, Ebenezer. These things are shown to you so you may learn from them. Will you learn, Ebenezer? Or will this journey be in vain? It is for you to decide. Ponder all these things that I have shown you tonight.
Tired?
Not in the least.
He was anxious.
Anxious for all that he had seen.
Anxious for all that he would see.
Bum, 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 bum. Bum, 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 bum. Bum, 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 bum. Bum, 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 bum. Bum.
Ah, 2 o'clock. No ghost. I've learned my lesson, Jacob. Thank you, Marley. Thank you. I've learned my lesson.
I'll be kinder to my nephew Fred. I'll let Bob Cratchit have an extra lump of coal for the stove on particularly cold days. Ah, yes. No further need to disturb my sleep, Marley. I am saved. Thank you, Jacob.
Ebenezer Scrooge!
Oh, no.
Ebenezer Scrooge! I am the ghost of Christmas present. Look upon me. I'll wager you have never seen the likes of me before.
Never.
Never walked forth with my elder brothers of these latter years?
I'm afraid I have not. Do you have many brothers, Spirit?
More than 1,800, sir, and another every year.
1,800? A tremendous family to provide for. Spirit, conduct me where you will. Last night I went forth on compulsion and learnt a lesson that is working now. If you have aught to teach me, let me profit by it.
We spirits of Christmas don't only live one day of the year, but all 365. So it is true of the child born in Bethlehem. He doesn't live in men's heart only one day of the year, but in all the days of the year. Ebenezer, you have chosen not to seek him in your heart. Therefore, you shall come with me and seek him in the hearts of men of goodwill. Please, touch my room.
Where do you take me, Spirit?
I am here to show you Christmas!
Hither, page, and stand by me, if thou knowest it telling. Yonder peasant, who is he? Where and what his dwelling? Sire, he lives a goodly Kent, underneath a mountain, right against the forest fence, by St. Agnes Fountain.
How much longer, Mama?
Soon enough, Belinda.
But where's Martha? Papa and Tim will be here any minute.
Well, she won't arrive any sooner with you staring out the window. Help your brother with the table runner.
Mother.
Thank you, Belinda. Then when you're done, come help me in the kitchen. It's almost time to lift the pudding.
And a Merry Christmas to all.
Martha, you're here. Mama, Martha's home.
Well, bless your heart alive, my dear. How late you are.
We had a great deal of work to finish up last night. And then we had to clear away this morning, Mother.
Well, never mind. So long as you are come.
What did you bring me, Martha?
What did I bring you? Why would I ever bring anything to you?
It's Christmas.
Christmas? I've forgotten all about that.
Martha!
Let me see if there's something in my pouch. No, nothing.
Martha!
Let me check again. Here's something. What could it be? Could it be a peppermint sweet?
What about me?
And for you, a beautiful hair ribbon.
It's lovely. Thank you, Martha. Mama, look what Martha brought me.
Oh, it's beautiful.
Where are Papa and Tim?
Well, you know your precious father, Martha. He probably stopped with Tim to take his turn on a sled or knock the hat off of a snowman. He becomes such a child during this season, I tell you. Giggling, singing, running about, playing tricks.
I know. Let's play a trick on him today. Let's hide Martha and tell him she's not here.
It's perfectly wicked. Can we, Mama?
Well, it would serve him right for coming home late on Christmas. When you see your father coming, call for Martha to hide. In the meantime, Martha, come on into the kitchen and talk with me, love.
Too late. Here they come. Martha, under the table.
Merry Christmas, everyone! Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas!
Boy! Right here. All right. Oh, good day all. Wait. Wait, where's our Martha? Not arrived yet.
Not coming.
Not?
That's right, Papa. She can't be here for Christmas.
Not coming. Not coming on Christmas Day.
I'm afraid not, dear.
No. Are we to have Christmas Day without Martha, then? It's just as well, don't you think, Tim? I mean, she would only eat up all the food and not leave any for the rest of us. Yes, children, I think that Christmas is better off without her. In fact, I think that this may just be the best Christmas ever. No Martha at last. Why in time, we'll forget all about her. You'll say, Martha who?
Martha who? Indeed.
Martha, you've come home.
My goodness, look everyone, it's what was your name again?
Martha.
Martha, of course. I knew it started with an M. Well, dear, I guess Christmas will just have to come with you here. I'll come home. Well, my love, aren't we the luckiest of parents to have all of our children home with us on Christmas Day?
Yes, we are. And how did Tim behave?
Oh. As good as gold, and better. And he said the most extraordinary thing as we were leaving the church. He said that he hoped that all the people could see him on this Christmas day, that he may put them in mind as to who made the lame walk and the blind see. Isn't that extraordinary?
Oh, it's extraordinary. Come, everyone, take your places at the table. Belinda, you'll help me with the pudding. Martha, will you bring the potatoes? Oh,
and Tim and I shall pour the cider. Shall we not, sir?
Yes, Papa. Everyone, if you please.
Right you are, Tim. A bit for everyone. Oh, Peter. By the way, I believe I have a situation for you, which, if obtained, should bring you in about 5 and 6 pence weekly.
5 and 6 pence, Papa? Mm-hmm. What a fortune. When may I start?
Well, oh, business later, sir, for here is the order of the day. Oh, yes, I'm waiting for this. I'm waiting for this. One more drink. And that's for you, dear mother. You ready? Such a pudding as I have never seen! Oh, my dear, you have outdone yourself this year.
Thank you, kind sir.
And now, everyone have their glass. And now, my dears, before we enjoy all that is put before us, may I just say a Merry Christmas. God bless us. God bless us, everyone.
Spirit, tell me, will Tiny Tim live?
I see a vacant seat in the poor chimney corner and a crutch carefully preserved. If these shadows remain unaltered by the future, the child will die.
Oh, no, no, kind spirit. Tell me he will be spared.
If these shadows remain unaltered by the future, none other of my race will find him here.
You mean he dies tonight?
I mean, this will be the child's last Christmas. But what of it? If he be like to die, he better do it and decrease the surplus population.
Oh, another toast. Another toast. To the founder of our feast, I give you Mr. Ebenezer Scrooge.
Robert, I will drink healths to Christmas, our family, our friends, but I will not waste one drop toasting that horrible man.
Oh, my dear. The children, Christmas Day.
Well, no thanks to him.
But, my dear, he has given me much...
Given you? Whatever charity he has given you, you have had to beg for. You are underpaid and underappreciated and treated like a beggar by a man whom you've given 15 years of faithful service. He cares nothing for Christmas, Robert. I'll wager that if Ebenezer Scrooge had his way, anyone who wished him Merry Christmas would be boiled in his own pudding and buried with a stake of holly through his heart.
The woman's hearing's extraordinary.
I'm sure he celebrates Christmas, Mama, in his own way. Mm-hmm.
I'll drink to his health for your sake and the day, not for his. A long life to him, a Merry Christmas, and a Happy New Year.
Is that what it has come to? The very mention of my name causes heartache and despair?
Ebenezer, I will take you to a place that the very mention of your name incites laughter and merriment.
Please, take me there. Lead, Spirit. I will follow.
Touch my robe.
Deck the halls with boughs of holly, fa la 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 la. 'Tis the season to be jolly, fa la 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 la. Don we now our gay apparel, fa la 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 la. Troll the ancient yuletide carol, fa la 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 la. See the blazing yule before us, fa la 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 la. Join the chorus, fa la 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 la. Follow me in merry measure, fa la 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 la. While I tell of yuletide treasure, fa la 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 la. Fast away the old dear passes, fa la 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 la. Hail the new ye lads and lasses, fa la 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 la. Sing we joyous all together, fa la 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 la. Heedless of the wind and weather, fa la 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 la.
Well sung, everyone, especially by you, Topper.
Yes, Topper, your voice stood out almost as much as the vein in your forehead.
Now see here, Fred, I think it's adorable. It shows a man of great concentration.
Or perhaps constipation.
Why, thank you, Miss Alice.
Indeed, well done, sir. And due to his exceptional skill, Topper may choose a game.
Oh, yes, a game. What game shall we play?
The game shall be yes and no. And I, the game's master, declare the first victim to be Fred.
I accept your challenge, sir. Ooh. I am thinking of an animal.
Alive?
Most assuredly.
Disagreeable.
White.
Does it grunt?
Indeed.
Does it live in a menagerie?
No.
Is it to be killed at market?
Oh, I hope not.
I know. It's a horse.
No, sir, not a horse.
Wait. Does it live in London?
Of course.
Is this animal a pig?
No, my dear, not a pig.
A cow?
No.
A bull?
No.
Are you thinking of a donkey?
In a sense, yes. In truth, no. Not a donkey.
I'm stumped.
Oh, but mustn't give up, dear.
All right. Let's consider the clues. We have a grunting, disagreeable animal that lives in London and not in a menagerie, whatever that is. It's not a horse, it's not a cow, and not a donkey. I give up.
I know. It's your Uncle Scrooge.
Oh, yes, my dear, my Uncle Scrooge. Oh, once again, I went to visit him at his office, and once again, I made the mistake of wishing him a Merry Christmas.
And you live to tell about it?
He has refused our invitation to Christmas dinner every year since we've been married. And now that we expect a child, he's colder still.
But why is this man so perpetually disagreeable?
Because he's a bitter old man. There's the end of it.
I'm not so sure.
Not sure he's a bitter old man?
Oh, no, not sure that's all there is. Something happened to my uncle that he refuses to say. Something in his past. Earlier today, he asked me why I got married. And when I told him it was because I fell in love, he snorted and said, "Humbug."
Oh, but falling in love, a humbug. And why not? He says Christmas is a humbug, and I'm sure he believes that too.
Well, whatever the case, the old man has provided us plenty of merriment tonight, and it would be ungrateful of us not to drink to his health. Topper, if you please. Though he wouldn't take it from me, I give it nonetheless. Merry Christmas to the old man, wherever he is.
Merry Christmas, Uncle Scrooge.
Merry Christmas, Uncle Scrooge. No, no, no.
As I've said, I understand the point, and I'm beginning to see that I've made some mistakes along the way, but I don't appreciate being a laughingstock to my nephew Fred and his crowd.
It was all in good fun, Mr. Scrooge. You remember fun, don't you? No harm was intended. Your nephew has a deep affection for you.
Where exactly are we going? Oh. Spirit! What is it?
My time is nearly up.
Are spirits' lives so short?
Mine is. Mine ends tonight.
Tonight?
Tonight at midnight. Hark! My time's nearly up. Ebenezer! Look here!
These children, Spirit, are they yours?
They are man's. And they cling to me, appealing from their fathers. The boy is ignorance. The girl is want. Beware them both in all of their degree. But most of all, beware this boy. For on his brow I see that which is written doom. Unless the tidings be erased, deny it. Slander those who tell it ye. Admit it for your factious purposes, and make it worse, and by the end.
Have they no refuge or resource?
Are there no prisons? Are there no castles?
Oh, dear brother, I've come to bring you home.
Christmas? A humbug? Uncle!
Oh, yes. If quite convenient, sir.
So you wish to remain anonymous, then?
Expect me tonight, Ebenezer. One is ignorance, the other is want.
Oh, dear brother, I've come to bring you home.
Christmas? A humbug? Uncle!
Oh, yes, if quite convenient, sir.
So you wish to remain anonymous, then?
Expect me tonight, Ebenezer. One is ignorance, the other is want.
Oh, dear brother,
Christmas?
I've come to bring you home.
A humbug?
Oh, yes, if quite convenient, sir.
Expect me tonight,
one
is ignorance, the other
oh,
is want.
Oh, dear brother, I've come to bring you
Uncle!
Scratch!
Am I to assume you're the ghost of Christmases yet to come? You have shadows to show me of things that have not yet happened, do you not? Ghost of the future, I fear you more than any spirit I have seen. But as I know your purpose is to do me good, and as I hope to be another man from what I was, I am prepared to bear you company and do it with a thankful heart. Will you not speak to me? Then lead on, and show me what I am meant to see. The time is waning fast.
The old devil's got his own at last, eh?
So I've heard. What finally did him in then, old age?
Who knows? No one cared to ask. Cold, isn't it?
It's seasonable for Christmas time. How long ago did it happen?
It says he died on Tuesday past, although he'd been dead for several days. Ugh. Terrible smell, no doubt.
Indeed. And the funeral?
Doesn't say. Although if there is one, it's bound to be a very cheap affair. For upon my life, I don't know anyone who'd go to it. What do you say we make up a party and volunteer to attend?
Perhaps if there was a luncheon, I might be persuaded to come.
Yes, it'd hardly be worth it if there weren't sandwiches, at least.
True, and what has he done with all of his money?
Don't know. Left it to his company, perhaps.
Certainly not I, nor anyone else, I'd wager.
Spirit, of whom do they speak?
Step lively, step lively. Come in quickly, I say. We have here Mrs. Pennyroyal. Do I spy silver trinkets?
Aye, spoons and plenty of them.
Very nice indeed. And these, candlesticks?
Aye, for holding candles.
Indeed they are, Mrs. Pennyroyal. Indeed they are. Let me see. Well, this silver needs polish, and of course the candlesticks are without candles. 1 pound.
1 pound 7.
Shrewd, Mrs. Pennyroyal, shrewd, but that's your account, and I wouldn't give you another sixpence if I were to be boiled for not doing it. Who's next?
1 pound 4.
1 pound 2, and not a penny more.
Thank you, sir.
I always give too much to the ladies. It's a weakness of mine. And that's how I ruin myself.
Now undo my bundle, Joe.
What do you call this? Bed curtains?
Aye, bed curtains.
You don't mean to tell me you took them down rings and all with him lying there?
Well, yes, I did, and why not?
You were born to make your fortune, Mrs. Dover, and you'll certainly do it. Let me see what else you have.
Oh, be careful. Don't get any oil on his blankets.
His blankets?
Why, who else's do you think they'd be? I mean, he's not likely to take cold without them.
I hope you didn't dive anything catching, eh?
Well, I wasn't so fond of his company that I'd be loitering about him for such things. Ah, you can look through that shirt until your eyes ache. There's not a hole in it, not a threadbare place. Why, it's the best he had, and a fine one too. And besides, if it hadn't been for me, they'd have wasted it.
Wasted it? How would they have wasted it, Mrs. Dober?
By burying him in it, for sure. Why, someone was fool enough to do it, but I took it off again. If calico isn't good enough for such a purpose, it ain't good enough for anything. Besides, he couldn't have looked any uglier than he did in that one.
And this is the end of it, you see. He frightened everyone away from him when he was alive so that he could profit us when he was dead.
Spirit, I see. The case of this unhappy man might well be my own. My life tends that way now. Is there any person in the town that feels any emotion caused by this man's death? Show that person to me, Spirit, I beseech you!
Oh, there you are. Is it bad news, Thomas, or good?
Bad.
Oh, we are quite ruined then?
No, there is still hope yet.
Oh, if he relents, you mean, which he never will. We're ruined.
He's past relenting, Caroline. He's dead.
Dead?
Quite dead.
Oh, well, then to whom will our debts be transferred?
We won't know yet. It'll take at least 6 weeks for all notes to be transferred. And by then we'll have the money. And even if we don't, what are the odds of the next landlord being as merciless as this one was?
Oh, well then it is good news, Thomas.
Wonderful news, Caroline. We can sleep with light hearts tonight. We are saved!
Spirit. Can you not show me any tenderness connected with death? Can no one treat the everlasting with care or concern?
Unto them and said, "Suffer the little children to come unto me, and forbid them not. Kingdom of God, verily I say unto you, whosoever shall not receive the kingdom of God as a little child shall in no wise enter therein." Oh, the small print hurts my eyes. By candlelight makes my eyes weak, and I wouldn't show weak eyes to your father when he comes home from work for the world.
Pastor, rather, but I think he has walked a little slower these last few evenings, Mother.
I have seen him walk with Tiny Tim upon his shoulders very fast indeed. But he was a small child, and your father loved him so. No trouble. And here's your father at the door. Have you made the arrangements, Robert?
yes. Yes, my dear. Oh, wait till you see how green a place it is. I told him that we would visit him often. My little child. My little child. I saw Mr. Scrooge's nephew there. He stopped and spoke with me and asked me what had happened to distress me so much. I told him. And he said how very sorry he was to hear it.
How kind of him.
He said if we needed anything at all, that we should call upon him. It really seemed as if he had known our tiny Tim and felt with us.
Bless his heart. I'm sure he's a good soul.
You would be surer of it if you had seen him today and spoken with him.
And I'm not sure that he might not get Peter over there a better situation.
Only hear that, Peter.
And then Peter will be keeping company with someone and setting up for himself.
Get along with you.
Well, it's just as likely one of these days. But however and whenever we part from each other, I'm sure that none of us shall forget poor Tiny Tim, shall we?
No, Father.
Or this first parting that there was among us?
Never, Father.
And I know, my dears, that when we recollect how patient and how mild he was, although a little child, that we shall not quarrel easily among ourselves and forget poor Tiny Tim in doing it.
No, Mother. Never.
Then I am happy. I am. Very happy.
Indeed, Spirit, I feel our parting is drawing near. I sense it, I know not how. Tell me what man that was that has died. I see my house, let me behold what I shall be in days to come. My house is yonder, why do you point away? Before I draw near to where you point, answer me one question. Are these the shadows of things that will be, or are they the shadows of things that may be only? Spirit, answer me. I must know if it's too late. Is there still time for me to alter my fate? Spirit, I must know if it's too late. Spirit, I must know if it's too late. Am I the man of whom they spoke?
no, 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 no. I will keep Christmas in my heart. I will honor it all the year. I will live in the past, the present, and the future. All three spirits shall strive within me. I will not shut out the lessons that they teach. Oh, spirits, please, please tell me that I may sponge away the writing on this stone. Please.
My bedroom. My bed. My blankets. My bed curtains. You're still here. My spoon. You're still here.
Ebenezer Scrooge. You old humbug!
I'm still here. I'm alive. Jacob Marley, heaven and Christmas time be praised. I say it on my knees, oh Jacob. I say it on my knees. It is morn. But what day is it? Have I missed it altogether? I don't know how long I've been amongst the spirits. I don't know what day in a month it is. I don't know anything. I'm quite a baby. Oh, well, that's all right. I'd rather be a baby. Ah, oh, what day is it? Hello? Hello? You there? Hello? Hello there, good boy. Hello there.
I wasn't doing anything, I promise.
Of course not. Pray, could you tell me what day it is?
Sir, it's Christmas Day.
Christmas Day? Of course. Then I haven't missed it. There's so much to be done. Do you know the butcher shop just around the corner?
Well, I just walked by it, sir.
A remarkable boy. Do you remember seeing the turkey hanging in the window? The prize turkey.
I do, sir. It's as big as I am.
Delightful boy. That's right, my buck. The one as big as you are. Is it still there?
Yes, sir. It's still there.
Good. Good. Very good. You're a fine young man. I have a business proposition for you, kind sir. Bring that turkey round here, and I'll give you 5 shillings. Bring it back in less than 5 minutes. I'll give you 0.5 crown. Do we have a deal?
Deal.
A
I dare say that half a crown is as good as his. And what of it? It's Christmas Day, and I have much back pay to render it. Merry Christmas, ladies. Merry Christmas. Gentlemen, 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 your patience, please. I hope you succeeded yesterday. It was very kind of you, but you forgot to put down my donation in your ledger.
Mr. Scrooge.
Yes, that is my name, and I fear that it is unpleasant to you. Allow me to beg your pardon, and would you have the goodness...
Lord, bless me, Mr. Scrooge. Are you serious?
Quite serious, and not a farthing less. There are many back payments in that, I assure you. Come around to my office tomorrow morning. Would you come around to my office tomorrow morning?
Will we?
To collect my gift.
Indeed, Mr. Scrooge, we will.
But, sir, if I might ask, why the sudden change?
Charles.
No, no. The good gentleman has every right to ask. Let's just say that I've had a touch of the Christmas spirit. The Christmas spirit. The Christmas spirit.
It is something funny, Mr. Scrooge.
Charles, we'd best leave well enough alone.
Come around to my office tomorrow morning. Don't forget.
We will. Good day, Mr. Scrooge.
Merry Christmas. Ah, troubadours! Excuse me. Do you know the carol about Christmas?
The what, sir?
The song about Christmas. The song that talks about having a Merry Christmas. The song that has the ships that say Merry Christmas. That's the one I'd like to hear. I'll sing it for you. The ships. On Christmas Day, the ships, la 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 la, some ships.
Ships come sailing in on Christmas Day. I saw three ships come sailing in on Christmas Day in the morning. Oh, they sailed into Bethlehem on Christmas Day. Oh, they sailed into Bethlehem on Christmas Day in the morning.
Merry Christmas. Thank you. Thank you. Merry Christmas. There's my young lad. Such a good boy. Ooh, such a good turkey. Such a delicious looking turkey. Not a penny in my pockets. A man without money in his pockets is a he's a happy man indeed. My young friend, come around the office of Ebenezer Scrooge tomorrow morning and I'll settle our accounts. I must get to Bob Cratchit's with this turkey. Imagine the look on his face when he sees this feast. What a surprise. It's as big as Tiny Tim.
And I believe that I have found a situation for young Peter there.
Really, Father? Doing what?
Oh, I can't say just yet.
Catching rats?
Oh.
Sweeping chimneys?
No, nothing of the sort. All I can say is, Master Peter will be a man of business before very long.
Business?
Mm-hmm.
Well, good sir.
I'm truly sorry for the insult.
Think nothing of it, my dear Martha.
Are we expecting anyone, my dear?
Not that I know of, Robert, but let them in and wish them a Merry Christmas just the same.
I guess.
myself.
Mr. Scrooge?
Cratchit? I thought I told you to be at work at 8 o'clock this morning.
Mr. Scrooge, you gave me the entire day. It's Christmas.
I beg your pardon?
It's Christmas Day, sir.
It is?
Yes, sir.
Well, then. Merry Christmas, Bob!
Mr. Scrooge!
Oh, Bob, I haven't lost my senses. I've come to them. Now, don't just stand there like a doorpost. Invite me in. Merry Christmas, everyone!
Oh, yes, 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 sir, yes, please, please, come in, come in. These are my children. this is Martha, Peter, and Belinda.
Who is it, Robert? Mr. Scrooge?
Good day. Merry Christmas, ma'am. Merry Christmas, everyone. But where is... Oh, no. I'm too late.
Too late for what, sir?
Oh, spirits, I'm too late. Poor little boy. Poor tiny, tiny.
Papa, I put the beans in the dish all by myself.
Oh, God.
Tim! Tiny, tiny Tim! I'm not too late. Merry Christmas, Tim!
Merry Christmas. Who are you?
Forgive me. I'm Ebenezer. I'm Mr. Scrooge. But you must call me Uncle Scrooge. You see, Tim, I've known your father for 15 years, and that's how long he's worked for me. Oh dear, 15 years. And starting tomorrow, he gets a well-deserved promotion.
Promotion?
Yes, indeed. He goes from clerk to chief executive clerk.
Chief executive clerk? Pardon me, sir, but what's the difference?
None whatsoever, Bob.
Oh, okay.
But there is a raise in your salary.
Raise? How much of a raise?
Peter!
No. Your young man has every right to ask. You're a shrewd one. Starting tomorrow, we'll increase your salary by 20%.
30.
Peter!
40.
35.
Peter, you're going the wrong way.
50, and not a penny less.
Agreed.
Mr. Scrooge, thank you, sir.
The pleasure is mine, Bob. You deserve it. Merry Christmas, Bob. A merrier Christmas than I've given you these 15 years. And Bob, I would like to help your family if you'll allow me. Now, Bob, I think you should do something with that turkey. I don't believe it'll cook itself sitting there.
Yes, sir, indeed. Dear, I'll just go put it in the oven.
That will take hours to cook. The food is ready now.
Then we'll eat twice.
Excellent idea, Tim. You can never have too much food on Christmas Day. I'll leave you to your feast.
Wait, Mr. Scrooge, would you join us for dinner?
Thank you, but no. Christmas is a day when family should be together. I have a family, if they'll still have me. My nephew and his beautiful wife are having dinner tonight, and they are expecting their first child, which means I'm to be a great uncle. Extraordinary. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Thank you.
mercy mild, God and sinners reconciled. Joyful all ye nations rise, join the triumph of the skies. With angelic hosts proclaim, Christ is born in Bethlehem. Hark, herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King.
And from that day on, Ebenezer Scrooge was a changed man.
He was better than his word. He did it all, and infinitely more. And to Tiny Tim, who lived and got well, he was like a second father.
He became as good a friend, as good a master, and as good a man as the good old city knew.
Curiously, he never told anyone of his nocturnal visitors.
Never spoke of Jacob's head appearing in the knocker.
Never mentioned tombstones or graveyards.
So no one knew what caused his extraordinary transformation.
All they knew was that Ebenezer Scrooge was indeed a new man.
And gradually over the years,
for Scrooge lived to a ripe old age indeed.
And the most miraculous thing happened.
People began to forget that Ebenezer Scrooge was ever anything but a warm, kind-hearted, charitable man.
It was as if he had been reborn.
And it was said of him that he always knew how to keep Christmas better than any man alive.
Not just on December 25th, mind you.
But a man who understood the true meaning of Christmas 365 days a year.
May that be truly said of all of us.
And so Tiny Tim's humble prayer is what we wish for all those assembled here.
God bless us, everyone.
Take your seats one more time, if you would. We'll give the cast members a moment to get in the back. They want to greet you all, but just wanted to share a thought with you. if I could. We are in church, and I'm pastoring the church here with my father, and I just wanted to take a moment. If you would, just bow your heads with me. We saw depicted tonight regret. We saw someone that had a lot to be sorry for, that lived a life that was sad. Things happened to Ebenezer Scrooge when he was a child and kind of shaped his future. And we know that the Lord works in mysterious ways. And through a very graphic dream that he had, the Lord got his attention. And maybe tonight you're here and you just came to see a play. You just came to see a production and enjoy the spirit of Christmas and hear a heartwarming story. But maybe tonight the Lord is working in a mysterious way in your heart. And maybe tonight the Holy Spirit is trying to get your attention and say, I want to help you change. I want to help you be healed from your past. I want to help you be delivered from your lifestyle. Be delivered from hurt and harm that may have happened to you. Maybe the Holy Spirit would say tonight that you can be free. You can be set free. And you can experience forgiveness. And with every head bowed tonight, do the cast members proud, all the work they put in, all the effort they put in to memorize this play, these lines, it would bless them so much if you would, by an uplifted hand, just say, this really touched my heart, and the Holy Spirit's dealing with me tonight, and I just want you to remember me as you close in prayer. Is there anyone that would lift their hand up and say, I need some prayer? Remember me. Anyone in the room at all, that the Holy Spirit touched your heart through this in a mysterious way. Thank you. Thank you. Anyone else? Thank you. Yeah, I see you. I see your hands. Amen. Bless you. Amen. Let's pray together. Father, thank you for using all things in our lives, even a play, even a presentation written so long ago, Lord, that on this night, this Sunday night, Father, your Holy Spirit awakened us to the truth that you can heal our past. You can forgive us, that it's not too late. That maybe we came awake tonight from something like a dream, from something like just living life like we're asleep. And Lord, you've reminded us maybe of people that we need to restore relationship with. Maybe go ask forgiveness. And Lord, we all tonight ask your forgiveness. Lord, for things we've done in our lives, the people that have raised their hands, Father, I just pray that they experience your forgiveness tonight, your peace. Lord, that your Holy Spirit will go with us as we leave and remind us of what we saw. Remind us that this does not have to be our future. That we can change because of what Jesus did for us on the cross. Lord, thank you for dying for us. Thank you for providing salvation, forgiveness, and healing. And thank you for the brave souls tonight that raised their hand and said, the Lord is speaking to me. Father, we bless you. In Jesus' name. Thank you all for coming out tonight. And if you need to speak to anybody, we'll be up here in the front. If you feel like, hey, I'm really stirred a lot, and I really want to just talk and pray with someone, we'll be standing up here tonight if you want to make your way up here, anyone. If not, you're dismissed. Thank you for coming.
Oh, first, I need you to state your name and your character's name for me.
Hello. Hi.
What was your favorite scene to play in this entire play? So what's your favorite scene to watch or listen to behind the scenes? Okay, so Marie, what's your favorite part of doing his makeup?
Wait, I think I know.
Eyeliner.
Until I get my speakeasy coffee in the morning, I just feel dead.
And you state your name and your character's name for me?
I am Jolene Brown, and I play Fan.
So what is your favorite scene here in the entire play?
That's kind of hard. Okay, so it's either the party scene or the beginning Cratchit scene, the first one.
Okay, what's your favorite character in the whole play? Obviously, other than your own.
No, probably Ghost of Christmas Present. He's a very happy, jolly, big man.
Hulk, I help to film these plays. I'm basically a legend around here. There's Colin behind the camera, and there's Uncle Rick, or Rick Oliveri, and Cole, who also films. Yes, hello, what's up? See, I'm famous, I told you.
And, alright, can you say your name and your character's name for me?
Hi, I'm Scott Barber, and my character is Topper.
So, what is your favorite scene to watch in this play?
I think I really like the Marley scene. Marley does a really good job of being both kind of loud and boisterous and like terrifyingly loud, but also like very like low and kind of calm, in a sense calming, in a sense of like, this is serious, and it's I'm trying to get you to understand how serious this is. And
but who is your favorite character in the whole play, do you think?
I'd probably go with Bob. He's humble but playful at the same time. Like both ends are a good thing. Scrooge becoming a better person is a great thing, but also Bob continuing to be Bob is fantastic.
So. Can you state your name? Your character's name for me?
Past. I'm a ghost of Christmas past. Danilo Bejia Rivera Montesino Vasquez by Jeanette.
Okay, and what is your favorite scene in this entire play?
Everything that I'm in.
I would say the same thing, yeah. Who's your favorite character?
The Ghost of Christmas Past.
He's a pretty solid character. Yeah. And which one of the lines is your favorite one to say?
I am the Ghost of Christmas Past.
Sounds good, thanks. Can you tell me your name and your character's name for me?
My name is Mike Saro, and I am Charity 2.
All right, what's your favorite scene to either play or like see in this whole thing?
Naturally, any scene that I'm in is the best because of the incredible acting and just the overall eye candy.
Yeah, of course.
What's your favorite character in the whole thing? You could say yourself, but also add another one in there. Because we've had a few people say themselves, add Donnie.
Well, my favorite character is anybody that has to interact with me because they're very privileged. So, and also Donnie, a natural actor, and I love his dress that he wears.
Yes.
I also love when he trips on the bed the first night of the show. Your name and your character's name for me.
Hi, my name is Brittany Paulzella, and I play the role of Alice, and I'm also stage crew.
Can you tell me what your favorite scene is of this whole play? You can say your own, it's okay. A lot of people have.
I really like it when, sorry Kai, but when Tiny Tim is dead. The performance from John Wyble as Mr. Cratchit is to die for. And it's so emotional, it's powerful, it's simple, and it's just done really, really well.
So who is your favorite character in the whole play, do you think?
Tiny Tim.
Yeah, he's so cute.
Yes, Kai was perfect casting, and honestly, I think it's one of the cutest Tiny Tims we've ever had. Marley's doing a great job this year. Pat Banner's doing a great job as Marley. And I like Donnie as the Christmas past. And then, of course, I have to rave about Mr. Tim, because Mr. Tim is my friend, and he's a great Scrooge. So.
Okay, can you tell me your name and then your character's name?
My name is Callie Gaiman, and in the play, I'm Belinda.
So, what is your favorite scene to either play in this or just to watch overall?
The when Tiny Tim dies, because I have my favorite line in it.
Oh, there you go. That works. And then, who's your favorite character in this play?
Myself.
Okay, this is the camera crew here. This is all of us. It's me. There's Colin behind the camera. There's Ricky. Yeah, give him. There we go. We gotta get the camera crew. The camera crew gives us love. You know, this is Colin. Okay. I'm Michaela. This is Cole. And then there's Ricky, the big man in the cell. Here we go. Yes. So, Cole, what's your favorite scene to shoot in this?
I really like it when Bob Cratchit, he comes down and he's placing the crutch on Tiny Tim's grave. I have a good shot of that because I'm like right in front of him there. And usually you can get Scrooge and Ghost of Christmas Future in the background, and it's a pretty cool shot, so that's my favorite scene.
My favorite is probably when Marley is coming outside the door. Yeah, it's supposed to be me. Hello. Wow. Yeah, okay.
No professional here.
Okay, so my favorite part is when Marley comes out the door, because the door is really cool looking, and I get to zoom in on Marley yelling.
When he has to go and put the hatch back, so it looks like Scrooge is going to kiss Marley right on the lips.
It's a good part, yeah. What's your favorite?
My favorite part is when I hit stop on record.
And you get to sit down?
Wait, can you just tell me your name?
No.
She's running away from me.
So, we were going to interview, but I think we'll come back later. Let's go. All right, could you state your name for me and the character you play?
Eric, and I play Christmas Future, as well as a caroler.
Nice job. All right, so what is your favorite scene in this play? You can say your own if you want.
My lines are pretty easy.
It's pretty simple lines for you.
And then what's your favorite character?
Scrooge. Although I have to say that, yeah, the scene at Tiny Tim's cross is very, very powerful.
Yeah, definitely.
Give me your name and your character's name for me.
Yes, I'm Joe Evans, and I am Fezziwig.
So what is your favorite scene in this whole thing?
As soon as I'm done, I leave. I love that scene. My favorite scene? Oh, well, I guess I like the one I'm in.
Of course.
But I'm also a caroler, and I do like the caroling. But I also... I'm touched by Ebenezer on his hands and knees in front of the cross, in front of his gravestone. Yeah, that one.
It's a really powerful one.
I really don't like Ebenezer when he's such a mean old man, though. No.
Okay, so who's your favorite character, then?
Oh, I could say Fezziwig, but I don't think Fezziwig is my favorite. Marley is an excellent portrayal.
So what's your name, and then what's your character's name for me?
Kai.
Your name's Kai? Okay. And who's your character?
I have no idea.
Your character's Tiny Tim, right?
Yeah.
All right.
He plays Tiny Tim. So what is your favorite line to say?
Merry Christmas, who are you?
Yeah.
That's a good one. I like that one, too. Who's your favorite character?
I have no idea.
No idea?
You're going to say yourself? Okay, so can you give me your name and your character's name for me?
I'm Samuel Pena, and my character is Peter.
I guess, what is your favorite part of the play? Your favorite scene?
Probably the end, where I talk with Ebenezer Scrooge and try to convince him into giving us more money.
Same. And then who's your favorite character?
Besides myself?
You could say yourself, but then add another character in.
Marley, Jacob Marley. Yeah, I guess that's my favorite character.
Thank you. You're good to go. All right. Can you give me your name and the character you play?
My name's Tim Gaskin, and I play Ebenezer Scrooge.
And what is your favorite scene in this play?
Yeah, they're all my favorite. The one I like the most is at the end when Scrooge changes.
Scene. Who is your favorite character? You can say yourself, but add in another one.
Tiny Tim. He's adorable, isn't he?
Oh gosh, he's so cute.
Of course we're not allowed to say he's cute, because he don't like that.
So, what's your name and what's your character's name?
Well, my name is Kenny Carfagno, and my character's name is Boy Scrooge.
Okay, and then what's your favorite scene in the play?
Probably when Peter is betting the wrong direction.
Who's your favorite character in the play?
Me.
That's what we'll say. Thank you.
But just your name and your position, we'll say.
I'm Marie, and I'm Marley's makeup artist.
And what is your favorite scene in the play?
I think either, like, the first time that they show the Cratchit house, or when when Ghost of Christmas Future, like, first shows up, kind of like Sub Bro.
Yeah, pretty chill. And who's your favorite character?
Future.
So, what is your name, and then who's your character?
Teresa Carfagno, and my character is Adult 1, 2, 3, and 4.
And then, what is your favorite scene in this play?
My favorite scene is probably, I really like the end when Scrooge comes out and says the Tiny Tim prayer.
Yeah, that's a good part. And then, who's your favorite character?
I can't be biased. I have 4 favorite characters. That would be Young Scrooge, and Turkey Boy, and the Tiny Tim, and the girl who comes out in the front.
Oh,
she's,
doesn't have a name either.
Yeah, she's nameless, too. Hey, thank you.
I'm Thomas, and I play Thomas. And my favorite scene, I have quite a few scenes. I mean, and I don't get to see the first act. I don't get to see the second act because I'm in the back. So, basically, I guess my favorite scene right now is my scene. But, and then what else do I have to say?
And then who's your favorite character?
My favorite character. I'm going to say Ebenezer Scrooge. He's my favorite character. He really puts his whole body into it. He is awesome.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Ready? All right. In scene. Ready. Okay, so what is your name and then what's your character's name?
My name is Matthew Brown, and my character is Charity One.
And then, what was your favorite scene in the play?
I'm going to have to say it's Marley, when Marley comes out with all of his makeup and, you know, setting the stage for the spirits to come. Yeah, that's my favorite.
Mm. And then, who's your favorite character?
Charity One.
I was going to say that. Thank you. Okay, so what is your name, and then what's your character's name?
My name is Leah, and I play Martha Cratchit.
And then what is your favorite scene in this play?
Okay, my favorite scene, I think, is the Fizzywig scene at the party and all. Yeah.
And then who's your favorite character?
Well, I love Scrooge. He's just doing a wonderful job, and he really embodies the character, so I'd have to go with him, man.
Character's name?
Benno. I'm just kidding. My name is Young Ebenezer Scrooge.
And then what's your favorite scene in the play?
Probably the scene where Bob Cratchit's crying about his kid that's dead, and he's just like,
you're like the
And the music just like breaks your heart.
Yep, that's definitely. My favorite. That's a good one.
And then who's your favorite character in the play?
It can't be myself, that's true. That's my favorite character in the play. It's probably Matt Brown, Charity One. Mm-hmm.